What's going on, everyone? First off, before I get into this, I want to say this is the moment we've all been waiting for, my 100th video. And I just want to thank you all for the support and getting me to here, to as far as I come where I am now. If not for N2SC4R and Magnum05, I would not be where I am right now. And this 100th video special will be a Let's Play on a computer game, Jeopardy 2nd Edition for the PC. Now, I've done the PS1 version for our Let's Play, but this is actually more realistic. The PC version is the exact same game. The realisticness is the difference in the PS1 version, and not only that, there's some stuff and well, I got something on my phone. Okay. There's some stuff on this version that's not the PS1 version, so what I'm gonna do is a normal game.
Normal game?
See.
Okay, so how many people out there?
Uno.
Player one, what's your name?
Okay, here we go. Sorry you can't see the screen very well with the camera. Shit, wait a minute. Want to make sure I'm not hitting the wrong key. Alright, there
Player
we go.
One, here's your buzz-in key. You can also use your mouse to write down your signature as well.
I will. Yeah, and it looks like I can do... It looks like it's the signature thing is better on this version than it is on the PS1 version. Whoops, no. Yeah, that looks like about how my hair right on paper. It looks exactly like it. Except it's a little better on here than it is on paper in real life. Okay, we're ready.
Get this show on the road.
Yeah! The Sony Pictures Studios. This is Jeopardy.
Here he is, the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
Yeah!
Thanks, Johnny. Welcome to Jeopardy. Have fun, and good luck to all of you.
Muchas gracias, Senor Alex.
Categories are as follows.
All right, let's see. What's the categories here today?
Art supplies.
Oh, we should get that.
Our Earth. Ends in double E.
E in quote W in quote, you know what that means.
Name the movie.
Oh, yeah!
Category is... Where are we?
That's a good question.
Let's get things underway. Player one.
Alright, name the movie for 100.
1972. I'm gonna make him an offer he can't refuse.
I sadly don't remember that one.
Nobody?
Nope.
This is the...
The Godfather. I should have thought about that, but I'll stay in the category. And I know some stuff in this category. 200.
1995. Houston?
Oh, I think I know this.
Player one.
What is Apollo 13?
You're correct.
Yeah! 300.
19.
Oh, this is easy.
I never drink wine.
Oh, damn it!
What is Dracula?
Exactly. Player 3 locked me out.
Name the movie for 400, please, Alex.
Oh, damn it.
1939. Ah! You cursed brat! Look what you've done! I'm melting! Melting!
There we go. What is the Wizard of Oz? Whoops.
That's it exactly.
Oh, see. 500.
1971. You've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Don't remember. I know Aubrey Scott Productions had this question, had this category, too.
What is Raging Bull?
No. Nope!
Not
right, sorry.
Haha, you fail.
Anyone
miserably.
At
no.
Here's what we were looking for.
Dirty Harry. Okay, thank God we're done with that category. Art supplies for 100.
A mop, one of these made from camel hair, is used for watercolors.
What is a paintbrush?
Right, you are.
Yeah! Art supplies for 200. Oh, video clue.
It refers to any drawing material.
Oh, I know this one. I know this one.
Not just the ones made of wax seen here.
If you'll just watch this, we'll show you the clue. Player one.
What is a crayon?
You're in fine form, so pick again.
Damn right. 300.
You may execute your oil painting on a wooden panel or on one of these, a primed heavy fabric.
Don't remember this one.
Anyone at all?
Nope.
This is the correct
canvas.
Question.
Ugh. Okay, 400.
Carrara is an Italian type of this material, popular with sculptors.
I know it's not clay. I know it's not that. But I can't remember what it was.
Nobody?
No.
What we were looking for...
Marble. Damn. All right, finish it out, 500.
This clear plastic sheet on which a cartoon image is painted sounds like a prisoner's home.
Player one.
What is a cell?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Pick again.
I spelled it right. And then W-E for 100.
Degania, the first Jewish kibbutz in Palestine, was founded near this sea's shores in 1909.
Oh my god, what's that?
Player three.
What is the Sea of Galilee?
Never knew that. Never knew that.
Correct. Boy, you certainly know your geography.
I never knew that.
N's and E-E for 200?
The two
okay, let me move the camera back.
Are the foil and
there we go. I mean, not the camera, the tripod.
Is that it? Anyone?
Nope.
Here's what we were looking for.
The EP.
N's and EE for 300, please, Alex.
Video clue.
The woman seen here and WC Fields
the tripod back more.
Starred in this classic little 1940
film. Here we go.
If you'll just watch this, we'll show you the clue. Player one.
I'm going to guess it. What is Little House on the Prairie?
Ooh, no, sorry.
Damn it. Nope, that's not anyway. That's not what it is.
This is what we
My want. Little Chickadee. Okay.
N's and E-E.
Never heard of that movie. Never heard of that movie.
Tenskwatawa, Tecumseh's brother, was this Indian tribe's prophet.
No idea.
Anyone at all?
Uh-uh.
Here's what we were looking for.
The Shawnee!
How about President's Monograms for 100?
R.M.N.
Richard something Nixon.
Who is Richard Milhouse Nixon?
Okay, I didn't know. I didn't know the middle part. I knew it was Richard Nixon.
President's Monograms for 200, please, Alex.
D.D.E.
Oh, I know this one. Who is Dwight David Eisenhower?
Absolutely. Pick again.
That was easy. 300.
R.W.R.
Ronald something Reagan.
Anyone at all?
I'm going to try it. Who is Ronald Wilson Reagan?
That's it. Exactly.
Yeah! Lucky guess. 400.
H.C.H.
Herbert something Hoover. I can't remember the middle C stood for. Uh-oh.
Who is Hubert Humphrey?
Oh, regrettably, no.
Nope.
Anybody? Here's what we were looking
for. Herbert Clark. Okay.
J.K.P.
Oh, yeah, I can't remember that. James something Polk. I know that, I just remember, but I can't remember the K.
Player one.
Let's see.
Very good. Pick again.
Oh, I didn't need the middle name. Okay. 500 ends in EE.
Answer?
Oh, Daily Double. All right. Well, at the same time, I'm kind of nervous about this, so I'm going to try it easy. I'm just going to go for, I'm only going to go 300. Okay, Alex, hold on, 300.
This Massachusetts town was the birthplace of John Adams and John Hancock.
Player one.
I have no idea. I don't have a clue. How do I... Good thing I didn't go all in on this. I have no idea.
Good guess, but it's not what we're looking for. Here's what we were looking
Brain for. Brain tree. Good thing I didn't let wager a lot. Our Earth for 100.
This outer part of the Earth shares its name with the outer part of a pie.
Player one.
What is the crust?
Definitely.
Yes! Our Earth for 200.
From the Latin for track, it's the path of the Earth around the Sun.
Don't know.
What is the orbit?
Exactly.
Damn it, I should have... I forgot about that.
300, please, Alex.
This satellite of the Earth is a whopping 2,160 miles in diameter. A lot bigger than it looks.
Player three.
Uh-oh.
What is the moon?
That's it, exactly.
I gotta get my shit together on these clues.
Where are we?
I gotta get my shit together on some of these clues. Video clue, here we are.
It's not the rent-a-car company, it's the historic landmark.
Oh, I know this.
If you'll just watch this.
My favorite basketball team plays here.
Player one.
What is the Alamo?
Exactly.
Where are we for 200?
Over 700 feet high, this presidential dam is the largest of its type in the U.S.
Player one.
What is the Hoover Dam?
Exactly.
Yeah! I'm doing so good. I'm doing better than I did in the PS1 version. 300.
An English column honors this famous naval hero who died in 1805.
Oh my god, I can't remember this one.
Player two.
Who is Horatio Nelson?
Absolutely. Pick again.
Okay. Our Earth for 400.
The highest temperature ever recorded on Earth was 136 degrees Fahrenheit at Al Aziziyah on this continent.
Trying to think.
Player
Uh-oh.
Two.
What is Africa?
You're correct.
I should have guessed that.
Our Earth for 500, please.
Some theorize that the Earth once had just one of these bodies of water, called Panthalassa.
I can't believe how well I'm doing.
Nobody?
Player Uh-oh, three. Somebody.
What is a lake?
Nice try, but
nope,
that is incorrect.
Not a lake.
Anyone?
Nope. Nobody.
Player two.
Uh-oh.
What is an ocean?
Absolutely.
Oh.
Let's do, where are we? For 400?
A historic place of pilgrimage, this English cathedral of tales dates from the 11th century.
If you'll just watch this, we'll show you the clue.
I have no clue.
Nobody?
Nope.
Player two?
Uh-oh.
What is the Lincoln Cathedral? Ooh.
Nope! Sorry. Not the Lincoln Cathedral.
This is the correct
Canterbury
question.
Cathedral.
Where are we? For 500, please, Alex.
Might as well finish it out.
These heavenly falls in Venezuela were discovered in 1935 from the air.
Player two?
What is Angel Falls?
Exactly.
All right, that's it. Oh, no, there's one more. There's one more.
Place of pilgrimage, this English cathedral of tales dates from the 11th century.
If you'll just watch this, we'll show you the clue. Player one.
I can't repeat itself. What is Canterbury?
Exactly.
There we go.
That's the end of the Jeopardy round. Let's take a
look. I got a free pass.
You're playing very well, player one. Yeah. Player two, you're not too far off the lead. You're in last place, player three, but you get to start.
How did that same clue pop up twice? I'll never know.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for Double Jeopardy.
Okay, that was a glitch. I don't know how the hell that happened. Okay, Double Jeopardy time.
The NFL.
Oh, I'm gonna get that, even though I'm a NASCAR and NBA guy.
Songs of the 60s. C in history.
Cinco de Mayo. You know what that means.
Cowboy talk.
Cowboy talk. Play with Rico's person. She's in the net. She uses her place in the negative.
I'll try Famous Fred's for 200, please.
This TV character is a dino.
Oh, I know this.
At a quarry in Bedrock.
Player one.
Who is Fred Flintstone? Flint, not Flynn. Whoops.
All right.
Gotta get that T in there so they won't accept it. Famous Fred's for 400.
Bronco Buster in 1895 was his first bronze sculpture.
Player three.
Who was Frederick Remington?
Exactly.
Famous Fred's for 600, Alex.
Craven Graven Image, played by Robert Englund in the movies.
Don't know.
Nobody?
Nope.
What we were looking for.
Freddy Krueger. People are going to hate me for not getting that.
Famous Fred's for 800, please.
I'm Too Sexy.
Oh, I know this.
Was this British pop band's biggest hit?
What is Right Said Fred?
Exactly.
Oh my God, he locked me out. I knew that one.
1,000.
I knew that one.
His Polonaise in A flat major, Opus 53, is called Heroic.
Nobody?
Nope.
Take a look. Here's the
second time I've been locked out an answer. An answer, I know.
How about Songs of the 60s for 200, Alex?
June Carter co-wrote Ring of Fire and later married this country legend who sang it.
Player two?
Who is Johnny Cash?
Exactly.
Songs of the 60s for 400.
Song including the lines, You Make My Heart Sing, You Make Everything Groovy.
Anyone at all?
Mm-mm.
This is what we
wild
want.
Thing. I don't know if it's the wild thing I'm
Songs
thinking of.
Songs of the 60s for 600, please.
Martha and the Vandellas had a hit.
Oh, I know this one. Don't lock me out, please.
Weather song.
Okay, got it. What is Heat Wave?
Absolutely. Pick again.
800.
Fittingly, it's the last song on the 1967 album, The Doors.
Anyone at all?
No.
What we were looking for
the
was this.
The end. All right, 1,000.
This band took I'm a Believer to number one in 1966.
I can't remember the original. I know Smash Mouth did the cover, but it's not them. I can't remember who slung the original
Anyone?
Version. Uh-oh.
Who are Paul Revere and the Raiders?
Oh, that's
it. Nope, I know that's not it.
Anybody. Here's what we were looking
the
for.
The Monkees. I should have thought about that. The NFL for 200.
In 1940, the Pittsburgh Pirates chose this new team nickname.
Player one.
What are the Steelers?
That's it, exactly.
Yes! I might run through this whole category.
It's the team name for Seattle's NFL.
Oh, this is easy.
Player one.
Who are the Seahawks? Whoops.
You're in fine form, so pick again.
Yeah, baby. That's 600.
On January 5th, 1996, this Miami Dolphins coach retired with a record 347 career wins.
It's not Dan Marino. I know that.
Is that it? Anyone?
No. No, senor. Uh-oh.
Who is Tom Landry?
Oh, that's
nope.
It.
I know that's not it.
Nobody? This is the correct
Don
question.
Shula. Okay, 800.
Answer?
Oh, yeah! Yeah!
You can make your wager, please.
I'm not going to do all that. I'm going to do 1,500.
Once on ABC's Monday Night Football, he was the NFL's MVP for 1956.
Player one.
Oh, I shouldn't have gone this much. Shit. I sadly don't remember this one. I don't remember this one. I don't know.
Ooh, no, sorry. This is what
Frank Gifford. Alright, well, I'm still in the lead. 1,000.
During the 1995 season, this Carolina team played its home games.
Oh, this is easy. Memorial Stadium. And to my NASCAR friends in North Carolina, people like Daniel Logano, Caitlin Vinci, Daniel Trotta, Emily Kozol, you're going to love me for this. Who are the Panthers?
Absolutely. Pick again.
Yep. That I'm dedicating that one to all of you out there. Caitlin Vinci, Daniel Trotta, Emily Kozol, all my North Carolina, Courtney Dryden, all my other NASCAR friends in North Carolina, I dedicate that one to all of you. Cowboy talked for 200.
If you're belly up or strapped on your horse toes down, you're this.
That's an easy one. What is dead?
Yes.
Cowboy Talk 400.
Western riders refer to the English style of these seats as postage stamps.
Player one.
What are saddles?
Absolutely.
Pick again. That's my favorite correct answer line in this game. 600.
A rawhide artist was a ranch hand who was good with this branding implement.
I'm making this look way too easy.
Take a look. Here's the right response.
Branding iron. My camera's getting low on battery. It's starting to run out of battery. I think we can finish this in time.
If you're downright mean, your veins are filled with this reptile's blood.
I wanted to try it, but I'm too afraid. I don't want to get it wrong.
This is
a snake. I was kind of thinking that, but I wasn't too sure.
This term for a southwestern tavern is Spanish.
Nobody?
Nope, I can't even remember this one.
This is the
cantina. Okay. This one looks hard, so I'm going to try Libraries 200.
A Spokane library named
for this is easy.
Christmas singer has many of the crooner's records and memorabilia.
Player one.
Who is Bing Crosby?
Exactly.
400.
The Greater Amman Public Library is one of the major libraries in this Middle Eastern country.
Anybody?
Nope.
Take a look. Here's the right
Jordan. Spot. Okay. 600.
The Theodore M. Hesburgh Library is located at this Indiana University.
I know it's not Purdue. I know it's not Purdue.
Nobody? Here's what we were looking
University for. University of Notre Dame.
Founded in 1701, this university's library is Connecticut's oldest.
Trying to remember. Uh-oh.
What is Yale University?
Damn, that was it.
That's correct.
Libraries for 1,000, Alex.
This Waco, Texas school's Armstrong Browning Library has items relating to poets Robert and Elizabeth.
Player three.
What is Baylor University?
Exactly.
I was thinking Texas Tech. I'm glad the good thing I didn't try it.
In history for 200.
Last category. Video clue.
Plutarch wrote of this queen depicted here. Plato admits four sorts of flattery, but she had 1,000.
If you'll just watch this, we'll show you the clue.
Don't remember.
Nobody?
Player three. Uh-oh.
Who is Helen of Troy?
Ooh, no.
Nope.
Is that it? Anyone? This
Cleopatra. Oh, remember, it starts with the C. You should keep that in mind, player three.
An alphabetical list of this Russian empress's lovers might end with Zubov, but we can't be sure.
Anyone at all?
Nope.
This is the correct
Captain
question.
Captain the Gray.
C in history. For 600, please, Alex.
Answer?
Oh, Gray. Everybody gentle with me when Johnny starts reading the clue. She's doing it all. Get it wrong. Oh, and I know this one.
In 1899. Player three.
What is Chile?
No. Take a look. Here's the right.
Oh, my God. I knew that.
C in history for 800.
Charles Martel, grandfather of this great king, hammered Burgundy in 733.
Is that it? Anyone? This is the correct
Charlemagne. 1,000.
The final answer of the round.
Bassianus was the original name of this Roman emperor known for his baths.
I can't even remember this one.
Nobody?
Nope.
Here's what we were looking
Carsada.
For.
Goodbye, players three. Adios.
Let's see how all the players are doing after the Double Jeopardy round. Player one, you've got the lead going into Final Jeopardy.
Hell
yeah. Player two, you're not too far.
It's over.
Player three, sorry, you can't continue on with us in Final Jeopardy.
Nope, you can't. Final Jeopardy time.
Crunch time, folks. Final Jeopardy. I'll show you the category and give you a few seconds to think about your
words. Okay, let's see what the category is first, see if I know anything.
Television. All right, go ahead. Make your wager.
There's no way I'm going to lose this game unless I do something stupid like pull a Clavin.
Player two, your wager, please. Player one, please make your wager.
1,000, I guess.
The final Jeopardy answer is as follows. Good luck, everyone.
Okay, let's see it.
A 1997 episode of this CBS action series guest starred Philip Michael Thomas and Tommy Chong.
I'm going to guess here. Not Seinfeld, that was an NBC. I'm trying to think. Oh yeah, fine, fuck it, I'll put it. I'll just guess it, that's just my guess.
Alright, let's see.
There's no way I can lose this game, even if I get it wrong.
Your question, player two. Sorry, that's incorrect. How much did it cost you?
Everything.
Your question, player one. That is incorrect.
I knew that.
What was your wager?
Just 1,000.
Take a look, here's the right
one. Nash Bridges. And I won, baby!
Congratulations to our big winner. Player one.
Yeah, baby!
Thanks for playing Jeopardy. Hope you had a good time.
So I got to win on my 100th video special.
Hi, I'm Johnny Gilbert. Let's
yep.
Up before we begin.
So long, Alex. So long, Johnny. Well, that does it for this Let's Play of Jeopardy 2nd Edition for the PC, which is also my 100th video special. I hope you enjoyed this Let's Play and this 100th video as much as I have. Hopefully, tune in maybe later. I'll share with you a video of something something really funny that might happen at my job tomorrow that I might post here on YouTube. It's going to be a Wednesday night special of the Thursday night presentation episode they normally hold on Thursday nights. So until then, this is Mark Oliveira saying, have a good rest of the day, everyone. And we're going to end it like this.